the family, it's food, it's the presents, it's the bank holidays, it's the vibe, it's just the season itself.
No, I don't like Christmas anymore.
What do you mean you don't like Christmas anymore?
I just spent another £200.
On what?
My car got clumped last week.
What happened?
Me and Christine returned the earrings I bought her, and
Wait, you bought her earrings again?
Yeah, she says she likes them. Go on.
I think there may be a clue in that she wanted to return them again.
Yeah, she says she likes them, but they just didn't fit.
Uncle Bruce, when have you ever heard of a woman returning earrings because they didn't fit? They're earrings. You men are clueless. Anyway, finish your story.
Well, I stayed in my car. I was illegally parked where I was. After some time, I get a phone call from Christine and she mentioned one of the workers in the store said only the card holder can return the earrings. So I told her to come wait in the car and I'll go to the store and get a refund. She refused. Then all of a sudden, she wanted me and her to go to the store and be a happy couple. I said no. Then she gave me the whole,
"You're the worst boyfriend in the world. Where's your Christmas spirit? Don't want to be happy."
So I did the wise thing. Parked my car illegally on a London road. Went to go fix our first world problem. Came back to my car. Lo and behold, my car got clumped. It cost me £200 on two sleepless nights. That doesn't sound like Christmas. It costs too much.
I hear you.
But all is not lost. Now I have currency.
Currency?
Yeah. So the next time Christina asks me to go out, I'll be like, "Babes, I can't lie, it's a bit tight. I'm still dealing with this whole clamping thing." It's like currency. UK sterling.
Okay, I see you. Is that how men are, yeah?
Not all men. Just me.
Would you marry her?
Who? Christina? Never thought about it.
Don't you think that if you get yourself in a situation, like, it would be a way for you to show her how committed you are to her? To show her that you'll always be there no matter what. For richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, clamped car or no clamped car. It's like currency. Kuwaiti dinar.
That's an interesting thought pattern for a 16-year-old. You sound just like your father. Have you called him?
No, not today.
Okay. Did you call him yesterday?
No, uncle.
That's odd.
I mean, he knows I'm here and he trusts you.
I know he trusts me. That's why he asked me to be your godfather, but that's not the point, Elia. You can't go 2 days without checking in. Give him a call. Check in. Leo.
I don't want to speak to him.
I think you can deduce my next question. Why?
Well, women have this monthly thing, yeah. So, well, this month, I...
Late. I'm gonna be late, Rich. What is it?
It won't take long, sis. Why do you always wear those earrings?
This is the third Christmas lunch this week. Presents, gifts, drinks.
Sis.
Did you order those jumpers for Karis?
Yeah.
And Chrissy?
Yeah.
And Naomi?
Naomi, Abigail, Aaron, Ampy. Yeah, it's done.
Well, that makes a change.
Rach.
Bank card, where is it? I need to withdraw some cash.
Speaking of cash, what did you buy yourself with the cash I gave you last week?
I decided to save the money.
You saved the money?
Yeah.
So you ordered all the Christmas gifts without being reminded. You decided to save your Christmas money this year. Did you hit your head at basketball club today?
No. Sometimes when you find yourself in a situation, you think ahead.
Have you been drinking? Come here, let me check.
Rach.
Open your mouth. Breathe.
Rach.
I have to go, so I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. But my investigation will continue at a later date.
Look, I need to talk to you.
Oh, why am I always late every time?
Just 5 minutes, sis.
I vow. Next year, I'm flying away for Christmas. That way, I think I might actually save some money. It's always about just presents and lunches and dinners and drinks. That is why I don't like Christmas. It just costs too much.
Rachel!
What's up?
Look, a few months ago, I met this girl. You might want to sit down.
No, I'm good.
So, we've been getting along fine. She called me a few days ago and said she's got some news for me. She said that she's
pregnant. You sure?
Yeah, I mean, I took a pregnancy test. Christina bought me one from the shop a few days ago whilst you're at work.
Christina?
When did you find out?
A few days ago.
And who else knows?
No one else. Just you, Christina, our doctor, and...
Her. Just her. I need...
But please tell me that this is a joke. That this is a figment of your imagination or something. Like, just tell me that you had a bad dream last night and you were nervous and you were sweating, but you actually woke up and you thanked the heavens that it wasn't true. Tell me that's what happened, Rich.
It's real.
This is a TikTok thing, isn't it? A hashtag prank your older sister thing, right? I'm sure I've seen that somewhere recently.
Chill, Rach. There's some things I want to ask.
Like what?
Like...
How do you feel?
What are you asking me?
Because you've been washing that same mug for the past 4 minutes.
Mixed emotions. Feels like I'm driving in a circle in a roundabout at each intersection. I feel something different. I'm asking myself all types of questions. When did this happen? Why did this happen? Who's the father? Did this happen by force?
No!
Well, thank God! That's one piece of good news today. At least we don't have the police knocking down our door.
Who's gonna look after the baby?
You're still in school?
Do I need to call the doctor to check in? I don't know, Leo. I don't know. But then again, I think to myself, what's the baby gonna look like? Will it look like you? Have your eyes, have your hair. Damn.
These edges are laid in slay. Damn.
Sometimes babies looks skip a generation. So it may not have your eyes or your nose. Maybe you have your mother's eyes.
Well, Mum's not around to.
But your father is. Leo. You need to tell your father.
No!
What do you mean no?
He's on a business trip. Don't want to bother him.
Well, it's kind of important. Look, it's easy. You just pick up the phone and say, "Hi, Dad, Merry Christmas. And by the way, you're about to be a granddad."
I need time.
Now is not the time for you to be asking for more time. Every second that goes by, that baby is growing. Don't you think Dad should know? Where's the mother right now?
Don't know.
And when is she going to tell her side of the family?
Don't know.
For someone at the centre of this fiasco, there's a whole lot that you don't know, Rich. Which is why you need to pick up the phone and get some sense knocked into you.
Relax.
Well, don't tell me to relax, all right?
Look, for you, calling Dad is easy. Cause we all know Dad's always loved you more.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's Crystal.
So this is why they call it kids having kids. Do you remember when we had that incident with that boy's bike last year? And then you got suspended from college for fighting over the stupidest little thing. And there was that incident at the police station 2 months ago. And to this day, we still don't know if you were telling the truth. But despite all your escapades, you're still under this roof. And so far, nothing you've done has managed to separate you from your father's love. I can never get away with half the stuff that you do. You're always forgiven, you're always let off the hook, and you think Dad loves me more?
I do.
So why don't you call him and tell him?
Can't you call him?
I could, but it would be best if it comes from you. You're terrified, I know. You will change when you hear his voice. Everyone does.
I can't. He won't.
Your body language, your speech, it tells me that you don't know your father. Remember that school play you did and you forgot all your lines? You cried all the way home. Do you remember what you said to him? You said to your dad in the softest voice, "Do you still love me?" Do you remember what he said?
Nothing can separate you from your father's love.
The stress of this whole thing has caused you to forget your father's words. I understand why you forgot. You just apart when it happened.
I feel horrible.
There's a saying, when you feel like you're worse, run to the one who loved you first.
That's sweet. Where'd you learn that from?
Some movie, I think. Anyway, how'd you meet?
What?
This girl, where did you meet her?
Oh, well, I was at a rehearsal for the Christmas production.
When are the others coming?
Rox just texted me. They should be here in about 10 minutes. Let's just start without them.
Cool. You ready?
Let's go.
3, 2, 1.
C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S. C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A-S.
Is this where the basketball camp is?
Does this look like a basketball camp?
Not really?
Congratulations on your discovery. Typical guy, don't know where he is or where he's going.
Look, I didn't mean to bother you, but if you could just show me where the sports store is, I'll be out your way.
I don't know where it is. Google it.
Eve, chill, it's all right. I know where it is. I'll show him. It won't take too long, I promise.
All right, I'll wait here till the girls come.
Thanks, sis.
I'm rich, by the way.
Whether you're rich or poor makes no difference to me.
Not rich as in money. My name is Richard.
Oh, I'm Leo.
We've got a rehearsal for some Christmas party.
Yeah.
Come, you ladies can't sing still.
For real? Don't beg it, you sing them.
Well, you know, I just had a throat operation and I need to rest my throat muscles before I exert them. You know, the sternoid, omoid, and thyroid, they need adequate recovery time. You understand?
Yeah, sure. Anyway, the sports hall is through those doors.
Down the stairs, past the cafeteria second door, on the right.
How did you know where
the... I know where the sports hall is.
You do?
Yeah, I just wanted to get you on rehearsal so I could talk to you.
You're a creep.
Aaliyah, I'm sorry. I just wanted to talk to you. That's all. Aaliyah.
Smooth.
Who is it?
Christina.
Well, why didn't you answer it?
Because I'm focused on you, the mother-to-be.
So it wasn't because of what happened last night? I heard you guys argue over the phone. I don't think you realised that it was on loudspeaker.
What did you hear?
Just stuff. Okay, so I couldn't make out everything, but I remember she said that when you look at her, she gets the impression that you're looking for someone else. She sounded hurt. You weren't responding, but that's all I heard. It doesn't matter. I didn't understand what she was saying anyway, so.
She's dramatic.
Is she lying?
No, she's not.
Well, if what you're saying is true.
You don't know her.
Who and you do? You and your 9-week relationship.
It's not a time thing.
You ask any sane person and they'll tell you the same thing. She's about to have your baby, Rich. You're both wrecked and clueless.
You're just mad jealous of her because you can't have kids.
Who told you that?
Years ago, we stayed at Aunt May's for Christmas. She was speaking to Dad on the phone at the back of the house. Don't think she realised the phone was on loudspeaker. I didn't hear the whole convo, but I caught enough. You've kept your business from us all these years, and now you want me to run and tell Dad about mine?
My business is mine to deal with.
Do you know how hard it's been growing up in your shadow? It's tiring. I've watched you all these years, convinced nothing ever affects you or puts you off. You know firsthand what it's like not telling someone close something important. Hiding. I'll make a deal with you right now. If you tell me what it's been like for you, I'll call Dad. Please don't run, Rach.
I won't.
Don't tell her that we spoke.
Why is it that something that's supposed to be a blessing causes so much stress?
People your age don't realize that every blessing comes at a cost. What car do I drive?
A Focus.
What car do I desire?
A Stang.
A Stang will be nice, but come at a cost. Insurance will be more, services will cost more, petrol will cost more. A Stang will be a blessing, but come at a cost. Last month I asked you what you wanted for Christmas. What did you tell me?
A 5-bedroom mansion in a New York suburb.
It's the same thing, Aaliyah. New York has cold winters, so you're gonna have to warm the house up. Gas bills gonna cost more. You most likely have a large garden. To nurture it will cost you time, energy, resources. And those 5 bedrooms will need to be hoovered. It's a nightmare getting you to hoover 1 bedroom. Let alone 5. And this baby will cost you all the above. And then some. Every blessing comes with a cost.
It's her, isn't it? You need to tell Dad first.
Dr. Hilbert wants to meet at the clinic. Please come.
You need to tell your father first, Leo.
Okay. I'll make a deal with you. You tell me what Christina meant last night. And I'll call Dad before we go into the clinic. You know firsthand what it's like not telling someone close something important.
Is that a deal?
Sorry to keep you waiting. Merry Christmas. I wish to thank you both for coming on such short notice. If I may ask, is this the first time you both have met?
Thank you.
Where is Aaliyah?
In the car, outside of Richard. They'll be here soon. Just wanted to give them a moment.
Okay. Shall we wait or do we continue?
Continue without them, please.
Okay. Aaliyah has given me permission to speak to you both. So having met Aaliyah for the first time, we ran some routine checks on her. And we discovered that,
Is she okay?
Aaliyah.
Yeah, told me how it was for her. She didn't run this time. You think you know someone? I said I'd call Dad if she did. So I will before the day ends.
Yeah. I had a similar tale of Bruce. But he didn't follow through. Either way, I've decided to call him.
We both need to. But ladies first.
Charming. Rich. Do you mind if I speak alone?
No. It's cool. If you need me to shout me, yeah, I'll be close.
Thanks. Baby girl?
Hey, Dad.
You good?
Yeah. I heard your footsteps in the garden.
What's that, babes?
That story you used to tell me.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Part of the fig leaves always used to make you laugh.
Always.
Where are you, babes?
I'm at the doctor's with Bruce.
Doctors? Everything good?
Dad.
Yeah?
I have some news to share.
In your own time, babes.
Dad.
It's okay, babes.
I'm sorry.
What for?
That I'm
not pregnant.
Excuse me? She said she was late.
Yes, this sometimes happens among women. In Aaliyah's case, it was an anomaly.
Doctor, she took a pregnancy test.
The pregnancy tests you purchase at the local store are accurate most of the time. In this instance, it gave a false reading. Sir, madam, I can confirm beyond a shadow of a doubt, Aaliyah is not pregnant. I'm not sure if this is good news or bad news for the family, but if there's anything more I can do, or if you have any questions, please let me know.
Thank you, Doctor. You've been very,
helpful. I think we'd best,
go and talk, William.
Thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Bruce.
What's up?
I'm sorry.
What for?
For history repeating itself?
I'm not sure what you're referring to.
Cinderella! You shall go to the ball with the Air Force Ones.
Thanks.
You can have it if you can have your name.
It's Rachel. And your name?
Prince Charming. D'Artagnan draws his sword. When you feel like you're worse, run to the one who loved you first.
How did you know I was here?
I heard your footsteps in the garden. I am your blessing, but I won't be Constance. Every blessing comes at a cost. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? That's the script.
I've loved you before you knew me, Aaliyah. Before you could comprehend me. Before you were formed in your mother's womb. I told you years ago that there's nothing you could do that could separate my love from you. That still stands, because time don't change me. There's nothing wrong with having children early. I just wanted you to have a foundation. Just so the baby's in line for success. But that's okay. This whole thing's gonna work out for your good, because I'm with you.
Rachel!
My love for you is so deep that even if you decide after this phone call you wanna run away, I'll let you go. And I'll cry even now until you return, because I know you will. And when you do, my arms will be wide open, because you're my blessing and love is the cost.
She's not answering my calls. I know she moved houses, but she never told me where she was moving to. Is she even in London?
Due to doctor and patient confidentiality, I can't disclose.
I'm the father of a child!
I'm probably going against my better judgment here by telling you this, but Rachel is no longer pregnant.
What do you mean?
When you hear my footsteps in the garden, don't be ashamed, baby girl. Don't run for cover. Run to me.
If you do need or want to talk, Bruce, I am a good listener.
If you make a mistake, you meet someone else.
My apologies.
Merry Christmas, Doctor.
Hey, Dad.
This is for you.
Thanks.
What are you reading?
I'm reading about the cost of Christmas.
Well, tell me about it later, okay?
According to the Bank of England, the average person will spend an extra £740 every Christmas. That's like 29% on what he would normally spend in a month. And they said the average family will spend around £2,500 per month during this Christmas season. This is money spent on travelling, presents, food. Christmas can be quite a stressful time. People love it, people hate it. But you know, to do Christmas, there's a cost to it. And it's starting earlier and earlier. You start to see the lights, you'll start to see the trees, you'll start to see the shopping, the sales. And there is a massive cost on families during this time. And you know, the whole Christmas period have become quite commercialized over the last many years. It's getting worse and worse each year and becoming quite taxing on individuals and on families. People buying gifts for people that oftentimes a lot of these gifts don't even get used, but just the thought of I have to buy a gift for this person, I have to buy a gift for that person. So there's a massive cost on families. There's a stress cost. There's a financial cost. There's a massive cost on the family. And you know, to have a blessing, whatever it is, whatever thing that we have in our life, that's going to be a blessing to our life. It generally does cost us something more. You know, if you're going to have a nicer car, then generally your cost of insurance might be different. If you're gonna have a bigger house, then the cost of running that house or living in a certain area, you know, a nicer area, there's a cost to that. So having blessings in our life generally will cost us, will definitely cost us something. And you know, I'll come back to it, but Jesus tells a parable in Matthew 13, verse 44 to 45, he said, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field. He says, which when a man has found it, he hides it, and for joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. So Jesus said in the parables, that when we find something that we value, when we find something that we treasure, it generally is gonna cost us something. And in this verse, he says, when it's a treasure that we put high value on, it may even cost us everything that we own. Now, isn't it interesting that Christmas time being about the birth of our Savior, the birth of our Lord, it actually cost the Magi something when they came to see the baby Jesus as he was born, as they came into Bethlehem and walked into that stable and found Jesus lying in a manger. The Bible says they didn't come empty-handed, but they came bearing gifts. And this wasn't pound shop gifts. This was very important gifts. The Bible says they brought to Jesus gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So the first Christmas, if you like, the presents and the gifts and the costs went towards the one whose birthday it is. And it's interesting in Christmas time that it's Jesus's birthday, but everybody gets gifts. I mean, that's the preciousness of God, I guess, or the preciousness of Jesus in that he blesses others even on his own birthday. And so there was a cost to these Magi as they brought their gifts to Jesus. Gold, precious gold, frankincense, which in the Bible, those times, these items were precious items. It's almost like when they brought myrrh and brought frankincense. This is not them bringing Ted Baker perfume. This is them bringing Creed. This is them bringing the most expensive types of fragrances to present to Jesus. So there was a cost on that first Christmas. Now, as I read to you, Jesus said, if a man finds a treasure in the field, he goes away and sells everything that he has, and he buys that field so that he can have that treasure. But Jesus also says, and the kingdom of heaven, in verse 45, is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls. He says, but when he has found one pearl of great price, he went and sold all that he had and bought that field. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that the first parable that Jesus spoke of, and he speaks about the treasure that's in a field. And we know from another parable, Jesus said, the field is the world. He finds a treasure in the field and he goes and sells everything so that he can have that one treasure. I believe this is speaking of God, our Father, finding you and I that treasure in the field, in the world, and pays a mighty cost to buy and ransom that field, to buy the field so that he can have the treasure. And it cost God, our Father, something. It cost God, our Father, the life of his very son. It cost God sending his son into the world, God himself manifesting himself, bringing himself into human reality and human life. It costs God watching his son suffering at the hands of his creation. It costs God watching as the human race mocked him, jeered at him, spat at him. It costs God seeing them plotting to murder his son, plotting to kill his son. It costs God seeing his son put on a cross and crucified, seeing his son whipped and beaten to a pulp. The Bible says in Isaiah, to the point where we would not even recognize him. It cost God seeing his son hanging on that cross. And it wasn't just he was hanging on the cross. He would have been gasping for breath, suffocating on his own breath, suffocating on his own blood, an excruciating, horrible, painful death crucifixion was. But this was the cost of God purchasing something, a treasure that he placed great value on, which is you and I. Ladies and gentlemen, Bible says we have not been redeemed with corruptible things like silver and gold. Gold couldn't buy you, money couldn't buy you. But the Bible says, but by the precious blood of Jesus. It took the life of Jesus to purchase you. There was a cost to your salvation. The other parable Jesus gives is about a merchant who's seeking beautiful pearls. He says, and when he had found one pearl of great price, he sold all that he had and he bought it. I believe this parable is talking about you and I finding the pearl of great price, which is Jesus himself. So we also are like merchants, and we're looking through life for something that's valuable. We're looking for something that's precious, and half the time, and a lot of the time, we're searching for it in the parties, and we're searching for it in fashion, and we're searching for it in art, and we're searching for it in gold and silver, and we're searching for it in music. And oftentimes when we accumulate all of these things, these cars and these houses and these holidays, we are left disappointed because it doesn't match up to what we're seeking for. But then when we find that pearl of great price, which is Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to cost us everything to follow Jesus. Because the Bible says this merchant sold all that he had. He valued this thing so much that he realized it's going to cost him everything to have this pearl of great price. Jesus himself paid the price to buy the field, to ransom us. Now for us to have Jesus, It's gonna cost us selling out everything, giving up our life, giving up our own freedom, giving up our own choices, giving up our own lusts, giving up our own desires, selling everything to have this pearl of great price. Jesus comes at a cost to us. We don't buy our salvation, but to follow Jesus, it's gonna cost us, brothers and sisters. The Bible tells us in the book of Mark, chapter 14, verses 3-5, that when he was at Bethany, reclining at a table in Simon the leper's home, the Bible says there came a woman, and she came with an alabaster jar, very expensive perfume. And the Bible says it was made of pure nard. And she broke that jar and poured the perfume on Jesus's head. And some of the people that were present saying one to another, why was this waste of perfume? It could have been sold for more than a year's wages, they said, and the money given to the poor. And they rebuked her harshly. This woman, who is nameless, recognized the cost and the value of this pearl of great price, Jesus. And the Bible says she didn't just come half-heartedly. She came with the best. And what she poured out was as like 1 year's wage. Now, I know we're all on different years' wage. But if we think of the highest to the lowest, she brought everything, all of her labor, all of her strength for that whole year. And she broke that alabaster box, that perfume. She changed the atmosphere. She poured it all out on Jesus. And this was a gesture saying, Jesus, I love you so much. I'll give my very best. I'll pay the price. I'll pay the cost to follow you. So brothers and sisters, this Christmas, would we consider that God himself has paid the massive cost? While we are paying the cost to have a Christmas celebration, God paid the massive cost of giving his son to die in our place, to suffer on that cross, and he raised him from the dead. And now we, like merchants, are seeking that pearl of great price, that pearl of great price. And it's gonna cost us giving up everything, surrendering our lives. I challenge us this Christmas, surrender your heart to Jesus. Give him everything. He is worth it. Sell out everything to follow this Jesus. And I'm saying, the Bible says, no man that has denied houses, father, land, children, will not receive something rewarding this life and in the life to come. No matter what cost you pay, it will never compare to what God will give you in return. It will never compare to the joy that you will get in return, the peace of mind that you will get in return. So we're encouraging you this Christmas, as you pay the cost to have a Christmas celebration with your family and friends, pay the cost to follow Jesus. There is a cost to Christmas, and Jesus loves you. And so, Father, I just pray for everyone watching that, God, that they would recognize that you, Heavenly Father, have paid that ultimate cost in giving your son, Jesus. And now, Lord, we as merchants are seeking that pearl of great price. Help us, Lord, to sell out and to give up everything to follow you, Jesus. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.